Notion is very popular among like kind of the productivity space, and I've given it a try multiple times. It's so popular, so I keep kind of coming back to it, trying to make it work, and it never seems to really work for me. And then it kind of dawned on me that I'm trying to use Notion as my one tool for task management. And Notion is an amazing tool. It's incredibly customizable. I love the looks of it. It's very clean, which is why I kind of keep coming back to it. But what finally clicked is that it's a notes management tool. It's not a task management tool. So if I'm using it for something it wasn't intended for, it's probably not gonna be the best, especially if there are tons of other task management tools on the market. So Notion is pretty much a glorified notes app, or like Evernote or Google Docs. It's just a prettier way to store your notes. Now, if you have a lot of notes, that's a great tool. And it is customizable to be able to do other things, but its original intention is pretty much just a beautiful note-taking app. But I don't need an extensive notes organization system. Even if when I go to meetings, I don't take notes. I don't bring a notebook. I bring my calendar and I write down action items. What I want is always, I want one tool that rules them all. One tool that will do everything for me. And it pretty much, I'm gonna need a calendar no matter what. So the calendar might as well be that one tool. And since I don't have a big need for notes, Notion was never that one tool for me. So I've been experimenting. I've tried a bunch. The one that I think is actually going to stick, that might actually finally replace my paper calendar, this is big news, is Sunsama. And I love it. It's incredibly simple, and that is what I like about it. It does all the things that I want it to do. So you can add tasks, and then I just plop it into the most specific time that I know. So if I know the day, if I know the week, if I know the month, and I put it at the beginning of that section. And then it has a ritual for daily planning, which I'm obsessed with because I have a daily planning ritual, and it like helps you think of things. So you have all these things and then you sort them by time. So it immediately helps you assign it to time, which I think is amazing. So you have a daily planning. So you could do that in the evening or the morning. You can select what you prefer. And then it also has a reflection for the day and a time to get done. And you say what you got done and like your reflections on the day. And I think it's so great. And what I love about it is that it talks back with different platforms. So if you happen to have a Google Calendar or an iCalendar, I like that it kind of talks back with my iCalendar so that when I'm using my phone, it'll pop up with things. So another thing that I really like about Sunsama is if you don't get something done one day, it automatically rolls it over. Where when you're doing paper and pencil, you have to kind of be remembering to kind of roll it over. So I like that things don't fall through the cracks. I love it. I love the focus mode. So it just zooms in on that day. And there's so many things about it. I love the planning aspect, the reflecting aspect, the focusing aspect. I have really been liking it. Now, the catch with Sunsama is that it's expensive. It's $20 a month. And for a lot of people, I think probably for most people, that's not worth it. For most people, I think that's very, that's expensive. Now, I'm obsessed with productivity things. So the joy that Sunsama would bring me versus a $20 bill, I absolutely would prefer Sunsama. It's so beautiful. It's so clean. It does everything that I want it to do. I did find there is a platform that's free and it's very similar. It's called Ellie.co, I believe. I haven't used it. It doesn't do all of the things that Sunsama does, but it does basically most of them and it's free. And so I think for a lot of people, that'd probably be the route to go. So yeah, I've recently started importing things to Sunsama. So I think the move-in process is kind of what's intimidating. I think that transition, and that's why it's kind of good to stick with something over a long period of time so you're not like transitioning all the time. So I first inputted all the aspects of my life. So that's like work, church for me, if you have like kids, then be their stuff. So kind of the aspects of your life. And I put those things recurring, if they're recurring. Friends is another category. I put in all the things I could think of with friends. Basically, I just transferred everything from my previous calendar. But these are some categories to get you started if you haven't already been using one. My bucket list things, budgeting twice a month I put in there, dates on the weekends I put in there, grocery orders on Saturdays, meal prepping on Sundays, laundry on Mondays, my reminders to quarterly plan, weekly plan, monthly plan, and daily plan. Personal development, like reminders to read, and then my whole YouTube workflow. And I set those all recurring, and that's just so nice. That is really the benefit of digital things over paper things, is the ability to set recurring things. That's something that I've always kind of missed, but I just like writing things so much. The other benefit is of, I think, besides paper things that I've kind of recently found, is that anytime I'd be out and about and I would think of something, I'd have to go on my notes app, type it in, and then when I get home, transfer it to the calendar, because I didn't want to, like, be carting around the calendar. But what I like about this now is I've got, like, the desktop Sunsama, and then I've got my phone Sunsama. So if I think of something when I'm out and about, I don't need to have all this, like, here, then here. I can just immediately put it into the calendar. So that's, because things can really fall through the cracks if you're kind of relying on, okay, I think of something, I put it in my notes app, and then I need to immediately put it in the calendar, and so things can really get lost in the shuffle. So I think that that is a really valuable part of digital things. The con of them, I think, is you could get distracted on the internet. So I like that Sunsama actually has like a desktop app so that it's not in a web browser, because I can get distracted, you know, and I think on your phone, it's easier to get distracted on a phone. So yeah, I've been loving Sunsama, but really just all you need is one thing that you personally like. It's kind of like what dentists say, like the best kind of floss is the floss that you're going to use every day. It doesn't really matter. Like there are technically better ones, but if you're not going to use it, then it's not better. So what's the best thing that you can do is what's most usable and consistent to you that you're going to use. Do what works for you. If it's not broke, don't fix it. If you already have something that works, no need to move on to anything else. If Notion works for you, keep it. If Notion didn't work for you, don't keep it. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Bye.